Peace be with you. In the waters of baptism, Father Jerry B. died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In life, Father B. cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Jerome received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of Father Jerry Beat, your servant and priest, whom you honored with sacred office while he lived in this world, may exult forever in the glorious home of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I will sing of the good things that God has done for me. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I will sing of the good things that God has done for me. Is the Lord and just. Yes, our God is merciful. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I will sing of the good things that God has done for me. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. The Lord keeps the little ones. I was brought low, and he saved me. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I will sing of the good things that God has done for me. I will walk in the presence of the Lord. I believed even when I said, "I am greatly afflicted.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Juan. Queridos hijos, miren cuánto amor nos ha tenido el Padre. Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Juan. Queridos hermanos, nosotros estamos seguros de haber pasado de la muerte a la vida porque amamos a nuestros hermanos. El que no ama permanece en la muerte. El que odia a su hermano es un homicida, y bien saben ustedes que ningún homicida tiene la vida eterna. Conocemos lo que es el amor, en que Cristo dio su vida por nosotros. Así también debemos nosotros dar la vida por nuestros hermanos. Palabra de Dios.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
I am convinced that all of us are praying that 2021 will be a better year than the current one we're in. For this current year, 2020, will be long remembered as a very, very challenging year. Worldwide pandemic, the fear and uncertainty of which occasioned the extraordinary measure of suspending public masses throughout our entire country and many other places in our world. The shocking and disgraceful racial violence resulting in riots and protests in many cities of our country. Natural disasters like an unusual amount of high number of hurricanes with enormous destruction in many of our southern states, or the devastating wildfires in the west, destroying millions of acres of forests and adjoining homes and businesses. Not to mention a hotly contested and divisive election season, and perhaps many other realities that will make the year 2020 a year we might wish to forget. We here in the Diocese of Wichita have our own unique reasons to consider 2020 in such a way. And chief among them is the deaths of six of our beloved diocesan priests, four in retirement and two in active ministry. We have gathered more than usual and more than we would care to for these funeral rites for our brothers. And today we gather for the funeral mass and the burial rites of the six of those priests, one very dear to us, Father Jerry Beat, who served the church in this diocese for 57 years. Some of you may know this, others may not, but Father Jerry Beat was actually the second priest of Wichita that I met. The first was Father Phil Allen, of beloved and happy memory, whom I had the pleasure of meeting when I was a brand new priest in 1986, because he had a relative, a niece in the parish where I was serving, and he came to visit, and I was able and honored to meet him then. But a few years later, in the early 1990s, I met Father Jerry Beat, obviously long before I became your bishop. We were together, happily so, on a mission trip to Guatemala. Our days together on that pilgrimage were very memorable. It was during that time that we also celebrated with him his birthday. But we were in that part of the world which he loved so much, having himself been a missionary in Venezuela. Those days were filled with, for me, life-changing experiences, a deepening of my own understanding of the missionary nature of the church, all the while encountering a wonderful people, the Guatemalan people. Although materially very poor, were nevertheless, like so many in that region of our world, rich in spirit and in the joys of family life and faith. For me, those days together with Father Jerry and the others on our group helped to change my perspective. And I am convinced that Father Jerry had a lot to do with that. On the day that I was told that I was appointed your bishop, the first priest I thought of was Father Jerry Beat, because I had never forgotten him. Such an impact he left on me in those days we spent together. Since then, and especially since my own arrival here as bishop, I was always inspired and encouraged, as was all of you and so many others, by his deep love for people, but especially the poor and those on the margins of life, like immigrants and the underprivileged, the downtrodden, the forgotten. I was amazed and inspired by his ability to connect with so many of these people, by his ability to speak their language, the Spanish language. But more than that, more fundamental than that, the way he spoke to people with the deeper language of his love, his warm smile, and his gentle presence. And so it is my honor to celebrate this funeral mass and to deliver this funeral homily for him, and to be with all of you, his family, to whom we give our heartfelt sympathies and the pledge of our prayers. To be with his brother priests. He loved our presbyterate, and he enjoyed being with each of us in our gatherings. And to be with the many people in this diocese and beyond whom he served with an undivided heart, with a zeal and a passion that inspired me and inspired also many others. When I think of Father Beat, I have to say, hands down, he is one of the most active retired priests I have ever met. I think he might have been busier in retirement than he was in active ministry. Father Beat, yesterday I was meeting with our seminarians in Kenrick, and one of them shared with me that when Father Beat had his health issues over the last years or so, and he would recover, and someone said very funny, in a funny way, the beat goes on. The beat goes on. And it surely did. Rather than exit stage left from active ministry and to rest and to anticipate the end, no, Father Jerry Beat did nothing of the sort. He continued to be active in so many ways after his last official assignment. We know them very well because he spoke of these activities so often to us, sometimes even in a challenging way. He was active in the Curcio movement. And when he learned that I myself had made a Curcio in my deacon year in 1985, he was on me like a wet blanket to get me to promote Curcio in this diocese. And every time there was a Curcio at the Spiritual Life Center, he always made sure that I knew that I was always welcome to come and be a part of that. He was active in that organization called Unbound, which he dearly loved. It gave him the means to promote the missions by inviting people like many of us to sponsor a child or a young person or an elderly person in a part of the church and the world which knows all too well material poverty. Again, like a wet blanket, he was in my office with folders and inviting me to be a sponsor, and would not relent until I agreed to do that. By the way, the child I sponsor has the unique name of Elvis, and he is from Guatemala. We know, my brother priests and I know, how active he was in providing substitute assistance to our pastors, especially in our parishes with Hispanic populations. He was also engaged and interested in what was going on in the diocese. I think he knew my schedule better than I knew it myself, asking me about this or that event or celebration as it appeared in my calendar in the Catholic Advance. And on those rare occasions when I didn't have something on a particular weekend, very rare, and I would make my way over to the priest retirement center, he worried about that as if I wasn't busy enough. And he said, what's up, Bishop? You got a free weekend? How did that happen? I enjoyed many a meal with him and my brother priests in the priest retirement center, hearing his stories, regaling me about his experiences in Venezuela and other places, his trips all over the country, preaching for the Unbound organization. And then, of course, like so many of our beloved retired priests, offering his advice, solicited or not. Brothers and sisters, I'm taking a long time to say something very simple, but very important. Father Jerry Beat will be missed. I will miss him. He will be missed by our priests, certainly by his family, whom he loved, and by the many people near and far whom he served with a Christ-like heart and manner. And it is our honor today to give God all our thanks for sharing Father Jerry Beat with us in so many unique ways. We heard in the second reading for our Mass today in Spanish from the first epistle of St. John these words: "We are certain to pass from death to life because we love our brothers and sisters." That's how we will pass from death to life. No one lived these words more, I think, than Father Jerry Beat. He loved people, and he considered people his brothers and sisters. This love was not only a part of his natural disposition, but also found its source and summit in the Most Holy Eucharist, which, like all of our priests, Father Beat prayed and celebrated faithfully for 57 years. We heard in today's gospel, the gospel passage from the sixth chapter of St. John's Gospel, the Bread of Life Discourse, words that Father Beat chose for this very Mass: "Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day." Father Beat carried with him throughout his long ministry this promise and shared it with whomever would receive his priestly service. The Eucharist was the center of his life, as it must be for all of us, priests and laity alike. I, for one, feel truly blessed that my life, many years ago and continuing on into our own day, intersected with a loving and faithful priest such as Father Jerry Beat. I believe that we all truly feel that way, and rightly so. I invite us, in our own unique ways, to pick up his ministry, the way he lived his life, the way he dedicated himself to people, and to mingle it with our own, either as priests or married people or single people in the world. To mingle it with our own by using the time we have well, by not sitting by idly and waiting for better days to come, by not worrying about temporal things so much, but like Father Beat and so many others, rolling up our sleeves and building the kingdom that is right here in front of us. That, I am convinced, was the secret to Father Jerry Beat's ministry and the source of his joy and peace. As you know, I began my reflections this morning in a somewhat addressing somewhat the sadness and the distress so many of us feel in these uncertain times, and for us, the uncommon loss of six brother priests in 1 year. But I would not want to end on an ominous note of sadness or distress. For as Christians, as believers in the world, as missionary disciples, striving to be fully alive in Christ, we view death as but a passage from one dimension to another, from a good life to a better life. And those who have gone before us, though out of sight, are not far from our hearts. They and all the saints are now truly and fully alive, as we would want to be, even to a measure on this side of heaven. Let Father Beat and all our beloved deceased remind us of what awaits us if we are true like they are and were to the mission of the gospel. Let's remind ourselves of what St. John promised us in his letter, that we are certain to pass from death to life if we love our brothers and sisters. Father Jerry Beat fulfilled those words in an excellent way. Let us ask for the grace to do the same. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Jerome received the light of Christ. Scattered the darkness now, and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Nuestro hermano fue nutrido en la mesa del Salvador. Recíbelo en los umbrales del banquete celestial. En tu misericordia, Señor, todos escucha nuestra oración.
Our brother Jerome shared in the priesthood of Jesus Christ, leading God's people in prayer and worship. Bring him into your presence, where he will take his place in the heavenly liturgy. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Muchos de nuestros familiares y amigos ya han partido y esperan el reino de los cielos. Concédeles un hogar eterno con tu Hijo Jesucristo. En tu misericordia, Señor, todos escucha nuestra oración.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Aquellos que confiaron en ti y que ahora duermen en el Señor, dales aliento, descanso y paz a aquellos a quienes solo tú les conoces su fe. En tu misericordia, Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
The family and friends of Jerome seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Estamos reunidos hoy aquí en fe y confianza para orar por nuestro hermano Jerónimo. Fortalece nuestra esperanza para que podamos vivir con la gracia en espera de la venida de tu Hijo Jesucristo. En tu misericordia, Señor, escucha nuestra oración.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Nuestras penas y alegrías.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Father Jerry Beat, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered here, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In honor of Father Beat's ministry to the Hispanic people, I will be offering the Eucharistic prayer number 3 in Spanish. Going to try to do that well. Father Jerry Beat and God might be the only ones who understand the prayers as I offer them. So we'll see how this goes. El Señor esté con ustedes. Levantemos el corazón. Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios. En verdad es justo y necesario. Es nuestro deber y salvación, darte gracias siempre y en todo lugar. Señor Padre Santo, Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, por Cristo Señor nuestro. En él resplandece la esperanza de nuestra feliz resurrección. Y así, aunque la certeza de morir nos entristece, nos consuela la promesa de la futura inmortalidad. Pues, para quienes creemos en ti, Padre, la vida no se acaba, se transforma, y desvuelta nuestra morada terrenal, se nos prepara una mansión eterna en el cielo. Por eso, con los ángeles y los arcángeles, con los tronos y dominaciones, y con todos los coros celestiales, cantamos sin cesar el himno de tu gloria.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Santo eres en verdad, Padre, y con razón te elevan todas las criaturas, ya que por Jesucristo, tu Hijo, Señor nuestro, con la fuerza de Espíritu Santo, das vida y santificas todo, y congregas a tu pueblo sin cesar, para que ofrezca en tu honor un sacrificio sin mancha, desde donde sale el sol hasta el ocaso. Por eso, Padre, te suplicamos que santifiques por el mismo Espíritu estos dones que hemos separado para ti, de manera que se conviertan en el cuerpo, la sangre de Jesucristo, Hijo tuyo y Señor nuestro, que nos mandó celebrar estos misterios. Porque él mismo, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan y dando gracias te bendijo, lo partió y lo dio a sus discípulos diciendo, tomen y coman todos de él, porque esto es mi cuerpo, que será entregado por ustedes. Del mismo modo, acabada la cena, tomó el cáliz, dando gracias te bendijo, y lo pasó a sus discípulos diciendo, tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de la alianza nueva y eterna, que será derramada por ustedes y por muchos, para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. Este es el misterio de la fe.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Así pues, Padre, al celebrar ahora el memorial de la pasión salvadora de tu Hijo, de su admirable resurrección y ascensión al cielo, mientras esperamos su venida gloriosa, te ofrecemos en esta acción de gracias el sacrificio vivo y santo. Dirige tu mirada sobre la ofrenda de tu iglesia y reconoce en ella la víctima por cuya inmolación quisiste devolvernos tu amistad, para que, fortalecidos con el cuerpo y la sangre de tu Hijo, y llenos de su Espíritu Santo, formemos en Cristo un solo cuerpo y un solo Espíritu.
Que Él nos transforme en ofrenda permanente, para que gocemos de tu heredad junto con tus elegidos, con María, la Virgen Madre de Dios, su esposo San José, los apóstoles y los mártires, San Jerónimo y todos los santos, por cuya intercesión confiamos obtener siempre tu ayuda. Te pedimos, Padre, que esta víctima de reconciliación traiga la paz y la salvación al mundo entero. Confirma en la fe y en la caridad a tu iglesia peregrina en la tierra, a tu servidor, el Papa Francisco, a nuestro obispo Carl, al orden episcopal, a los presbíteros y diáconos y a todo el pueblo redimido por ti. Atiende los deseos y súplicas de esta familia que has congregado en tu presencia. Reúne en torno a ti, Padre misericordioso, a todos tus hijos dispersos por el mundo. Recuerda a tu hijo Jerry, Jerónimo, a quien llamaste de este mundo a tu presencia. Concédele que, así como ha compartido ya la muerte de Jesucristo, comparte también con él la gloria de la resurrección cuando Cristo haga resurgir de la tierra a los muertos y transforme nuestro cuerpo frágil en cuerpo glorioso como el suyo, y a todos nuestros hermanos difuntos y a cuantos murieron en tu amistad, recíbelos en tu reino, donde esperamos gozar todos juntos de la plenitud eterna de tu gloria. Allí enjugarás las lágrimas de nuestros ojos, porque al contemplarte como tú eres, Dios nuestro, seremos para siempre semejantes a ti y cantaremos eternamente tus alabanzas por Cristo, Señor nuestro, por quien concedes al mundo todos los bienes.
Por Cristo con él y en él, a ti Dios Padre omnipotente, en la unidad del Espíritu Santo, todo honor y toda gloria por los siglos de los siglos. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Agnus Dei,
et solis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei,
et solis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei,
solis peccata mundi, dona nobis patem. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For the distribution of Holy Communion, we will begin with the east half of the church first, everyone on this side, followed by the west half, everyone on this side. If you are in the gathering space or Good Shepherd Hall, a priest will come to you in that area.
Vamos a empezar con el lado este de la iglesia, todas las personas del lado este, y luego con el lado oeste, todas las personas del lado oeste. Si están en el vestíbulo o en el salón del Buen Pastor, un sacerdote va a venir allí para distribuir comunión.
Live forever, and I will pray.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father Jerry Beat, your servant and priest, that as you made him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven, through Christ our Lord. Into your hands. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet Father Jerry again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul,
receive his soul,
and present him to God the Most High.
And present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul. Present him to God the Most High.
And present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul.
Receive his soul.
And present him to God the Most High.
And present him
to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother, Father Jerry Beat, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As is our tradition for the burial and rites of priests, we commend him now to the Blessed Virgin Mary, the mother of priests, And we invite you all to join us in offering the Salve Regina.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve. Ad te clamamus, exules filii Eve, ad te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui,
peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Ask that all of our guests please exit through the southwest doors of the church. Through the southwest doors of the church. Thank you.